In the not too distant future, next Sunday AD, there was a guy named Joe, not too different than you or me. He worked in a satellite loading bay, just polishing switches to pay his way. He did his job well with a cheerful face, but his bosses didn't like him, so they shot him in the face. Was sending cheesy movies, the worst ever made. Joe says when you got lemons, you make lemonade. Now keep in mind he can't control when the movies begin or end, because he used the extra parts to make his robot friends.
Robot roll call. Gamma, Servo, Gypsy, Crow.
If you're wondering how he eats and breathes and other science facts, just repeat yourself, it's just the show. I should really just relax. For Mystery Science Theater 3000.
Hey, thanks for coming to Mystery Science Theater 3000. My name is Joel Hodson, and today's movie is Gameron versus Baragon, which I think is an anagram for Gameron. It's a Japanese movie about an anatomically mutated turtle. Now, thinking back, you know, Teenage Ninja Mutant Turtles isn't all that weird after all when you think about it. Anyway, can we have the phone number up on the screen, Cambot? We got a lot of calls last week, and we'd like you to call in and leave your message or comment if you'd like. I'd like to play one of those. Cambot, could you decode it and give me a CG with a Starfield background? Here it is.
Today's the 27th, and I just watched the program with my 3-year-old and 6-year-old. It was so good. It was really fun, and I hope to see a lot more of it. Thanks.
And that wasn't even one of our better ones. Anyway, let's get back to the movie. We got movie sign. Anyway, it's Gameron versus Baragon. You'll believe a giant mutated anatomically correct turtle can fly. Last week, everybody, it sure helps out here on the satellite. I love to get your messages.
Hey, Joe, let's listen to one of the messages.
All right, that's a good idea. Cambot, could you give it to me on a blue Starfield screen? And give it to me one time, CG, bold Helvetica, straight up on two.
Enjoyed the movie, but really hated the constant interruptions that were on there. It's like being in a theater with a bunch of rude junior high teenagers. I hope you don't continue the program. Not in that fashion, anyway.
What a complete wingnut!
Well, listen, Servo, everybody is entitled to their opinion. That's what makes the USA great, you know.
Is that so, Joel Hodson?
Mm-hmm.
I think that guy needs an antispasmodic.
Could I say something to our friendly caller, Joel?
Of course, Servo, yeah.
Hey, buddy, is that your head or did your neck blow up bubble?
Hey, you should talk. Listen, I think we should listen to another one.
More,
give me more, one more!
Oh, he must be Dave Moore.
No, he's on TV4.
No, that's Moore on 4.
No, that's a black gospel singing group.
No, that's Moore by 4.
Isn't that an off-road truck?
No, that's a 4x4.
No, you're thinking of a 2x4.
No, that's a CB term, you know, 2-4, good buddy.
No, that's 10-4. No, that's a tax form you fill out.
No, that's WD-40.
Chapstick over on the upper lip. Okay. Now, by applying the chapstick over on the upper lip and a little on the lower, it brings out your features.
I feel.
How are you doing, Crow?
Good. Tastes good. Feels good.
Is good?
Good.
Okay. Well, listen, it's time to... Cambot, could you bring it in a little bit? It's time to play another message. Do the same imaging as before.
Hello, satellite of love. This is Dave from Minneapolis. I think you should have less movie and more chapstick on your show.
Master, what does he want from us? We're using all the chance thing we can.
I know, honey. Listen, I know it's hard. It's okay.
Well, I understand how she feels. She's got the biggest lips on the ship. In fact, she's the only robot with lips.
Yeah, I know. I made her that way. Well, listen, I think we're only thinking of ourselves, robots. I think next week we'll try to work in even more chapstick. Oh, we got movies time. We'll see you on the other...
Chapstick, and it really helps our...
I'm sick of it.
I've been thinking about this chapstick, and it really helps our side to use as much chapstick as possible. Although as a lubricant, it's awful. I prefer 10W-40, or 10W-30 in the winter, or 5W-30, or any lubricant with a heavy viscosity. You know, many orifices of the body produce their own lubricants or secretions. My favorite orifices are the nose, the ear. The ear produces a gelatinous wax-like substance, which can be removed with a swab. Not to be confused with a swabby. Remember, never stick anything in your ear larger than a pirate. This could cause severe pillaging. Arr, Jim boy, pieces of eight. What's in those barrels anyway?
Bro, get a grip on yourself.
Oh, hey, perhaps the caller said slapstick, not chapstick.
Movie silence, cheese it.
Do you have Prince Albert in the can?
Why, yes, we do. Regular decaffeinated.
You better let him out. He'll suffocate.
Hey, come on, you guys. Hey, this communicator is not a toy.
We called Domino's on Earth, and we ordered 30 of your Earth pizzas.
And we're going to get them free for sure, because there's no way they can get them to us at all.
That makes a lot of sense, Servo. Really good.
And we learned something else. You can order pizza for other people, too.
I sure hope Dan Quayle is hungry.
Oh, great. You know, that's about as funny as, like, plastic doggy do.
What's a doggy do?
Well, let's see. What's a doggy do? Well, some days they're in the street, and sometimes they dream.
Okay,
and
I put the name on the screen. Call us back, okay, if you have any messages. Thanks a lot.
Sometimes
good night.
Sometimes they smell your crotch, and sometimes they stare at the wall, and sometimes they chase a stick or cars or bark at the mailman and chew your shoes and scratch the door, and then sometimes their favorite toy gets stuck under the couch. I hate when that happens. But you can pretend you can throw a stick, and they'll chase it, and cats won't do that, though. Cats are dumb. Cats will lick them. And
a naval lieutenant with a...
That he preserved the moment in pictures yesterday, so why don't you run that and show what happened when we froze?
Hey, Joe! I looked up suspended animation in the dictionary, and I don't think that this is going to be any good at all.
See, I told you guys it would work. So, anyway, we had such a great response last week from showing the Gameron versus Baragon film, which was about the giant turtle facing off with the giant lizard with the battering ram tongue, that I dug into the archives and found the original Gameron, self-titled Gameron EP. Anyway, you'll believe a giant mutated turtle can fly. We got movie sign. I'll see you on the other side. Bye.
Hey, it's Servo.
Hello, Joe. Hey. Oh, I almost tipped over there.
How you doing?
Well, hey. So that's what a tree on Earth looks like.
Yeah.
See, I like the way the barium frost matches his left lower mandible fluid stabilizer. It's very refreshing and stylish all around. I'm pleased you picked Crow to freeze.
Yeah, well, it was completely an aesthetic decision, Servo. You know, he's the most spindly of you robots, and it looks more like a tree on Earth, you know?
And thank goodness for that.
Well, don't get too uppity, because I've been scouting you for maybe the Frosty the Snowman carbon... Yeah, cryogenetically sealed lawn ornament to be strapped to the hull of the ship maybe next year.
Anything to serve you, Joel, my master figurehead and center of my life. Beep. Joel, I really hate it when you program me to answer that way.
Yeah, well, it's just what I do sometimes. It's what I like to do. Anyway, Kamba, can
twisted.
We... Well, I may be, but Kamba, can you put us up? Maybe let's have a Punky Brewster slate. We're going to do a phone message here and do the lettering in bold Helvetica up on the CG on to now.
Still haven't said who does your hair.
Uh-oh.
Oh,
he didn't watch the credits last week, did he? Some of you know what we mean. Canbot, let's roll the credits and stop at the thing we're looking for. Also, people, it's not the end of the show. We're just going to show the credits, okay? Let's see that.
Remember. Everything's rolling along nicely. That's you.
Yep.
Hey, that's you again.
Yeah.
What's a puppet operator, Joe?
No, it's nothing, really. See, there it is.
There it is.
Sir.
Maybe watch next time.
Pretty good. Godzilla or something. He'd be pretty good.
All right. Thanks for calling in. We really appreciate you callers, and keep the calls coming in because we really appreciate it. It helps us keep what we got going. Anyway, that gives me an idea. Gypsy, why don't you do that impression that you do?
Huh?
You know, the one we worked on at dinner time last night.
What?
You know, Godzilla.
No.
Don't worry, honey. Come on, it's funny.
No.
I think it's funny.
Embarrassing.
No, come on, do it. It's cute.
No, all right. Okay.
Just do it.
Okay. Boom. 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 Boom.
Yeah, that's good. Didn't she? She did a good job, didn't she? That's good, honey. Anyway. A lot of people have recognized that this first Gameron film is in black and white, and since there's been so much controversy over Ted Turner colorizing all those classic MGM movies, I thought it'd be time to do a popular opinion survey. Use your phones, call us at 623-7655, and now, Canbot, could you put the messages up on the screen or the quiz questions? First quiz question is... Is Ted Turner dumb enough to colorize the beginning to The Wizard of Oz?
Nolan, with your answer.
Right. Question number two. Does it bother Ted Turner that people watch his colorized films on black and white TV?
Colin, let us know what you think.
Question number three. Given Ted's obsession with colorizing things, is it possible he's the unwanted love child of Ike and Tina Turner?
Give us a call. Tell us your answer.
Now, give us a call at 623-7655.
Five, five.
Or just leave a message with us. Anyway, we got movie sign. Let's go. Canbot, can you give it to me up on the blue chicken slate that you got in the archives?
Helvetica Bowl.
Yeah, and give it to me one time heavy on the 30 weight, my friend.
Yeah, Joel, I'm a member of the Coalition of Friends for Giant Mutant Turtles, and I'm just glad that you showed this movie tonight to help promote our cause. And you know, Giant Mutant Turtles aren't really all that bad. It's, you know, they breathe fire and shit, but, you know, that's cool. They're good at weenie roasts and stuff. And I want to thank you for showing the movie again.
And, Servo, just to show we don't play favorites around here, Mystery Science Theater, what?
There's an and? All right, go on.
An and? Anyway, just to show we don't play favorites, here's a message from the other side of the fence. This time, Canbot, give it to me on the Globe Slate, and Bold Helvetica type again.
Yeah, Joel, I'm from the Friends of a Coalition of Giant Slimy Lizards with Long Nasty Tongues, and we think that the Turtle Coalition is way out of line. The fight was rigged, if you didn't see it. You saw it, but the fight looked like it was rigged. The Turtle had a couple low blows there, and we don't think it's right, so we're going to stage a protest in front of your house.
Well, I'm no giant mutated...
Turtle Wrestling Commissioner, but I do know what I like, and that's plenty of action, fast and furious, isn't it?
Yep.
So
fired action. Right. Gambot, put up the footage.
Yeah, let's see the footage, and we can make a couple of quick decisions.
Do it.
Point of contention right here, the illegal tail hold.
Look at that, gorilla.
Backbreaker coming up.
Oh, the burning front foot.
But he's got the bulk to withstand that kind of treatment, luckily. Uh-oh, battering tongue.
Uh-oh, he's turned it off.
He's been turtle
back. He's rolled into the lake.
He's getting ready for the flying suplex.
He's tucked into his shell. It's a good decoy.
Headbutt, can we expect a headbutt? Uh-oh.
Slammed to the face. Could that be right?
Well, what did you think of that, Servo?
Well, there were some discrepancies, but all in all, I'd say fair fight.
That's what I'd say. We got movie signed. We'll see you on the other side. Hey, everybody, thanks. Hey, Gypsy.
Hey,
come on over here. Yeah. Hey, everybody, thanks a lot for calling, and we really appreciate it up here on the satellite of love, don't we, Gypsy?
Yeah.
Anyway, Cambot, could you put that number on the screen now? It's 623-7655. Give us a call and give us your responses. Anyway, doesn't the tree look great, Gypsy?
That's not a tree. That's grow.
Well, yeah, but we couldn't, we don't have an actual tree up on the ship.
What happened?
Well, why don't we run the footage again, Cambot, and we'll show them that.
Hey, Joel, I looked up suspended animation in the dictionary, and I don't think that this is going to be any good at all.
See, I told you guys it would work.
Well, it's not really beautiful, but why?
Well, because it's we have a Christmas tree on Earth to represent a special time of giving. That's Christmas, because we celebrate when the wise men came and gave gifts to the Savior child.
Gifts?
Hmm. Yeah.
Well,
we exchange them.
What if you're Jewish?
Well, if you're Jewish, then you celebrate Hanukkah, and the kids who are Jewish get to exchange gifts too, and that represents another miracle where the lamp burned in the temple for 8 days, and it only had enough fuel for one.
Oil? Hanukkah, Christmas, you be the judge.
Let's sing that song, O Tannenbaum.
O Tannenbaum, O Tannenbaum, how lovely are your appendages,
O Tannenbaum.
Coming up.
Hey, thanks, and welcome to Mystery Science Theater 3000. This is our sixth transmission from the satellite of love. Thanks a lot for calling in. And by the way, why not play a joke on your friends? Call them up. Ask him to watch the show. Your eyes won't believe what your hands have done. Hiya, Gypsy.
Hello.
What's shaking?
Phone calls.
Oh, yeah, that's right, phone calls. Thanks a lot for all your calls in. And by the way, all you scary guys with the low IQs, don't call anymore because you're scaring Gypsy.
Yeah, grow a brain already.
Yeah.
Let's do the phone calls.
Okay, Cambot, can you give me a blue star field with a... Okay, bold Helvetica type. Give it to me one time on the 30 weight.
7:54 p.m.
Gamera the flying turtle is pretty neat, I must admit, but 2 weeks in a row is a little ridiculous.
Well...
Yeah, we agree with you. There's really nothing we can do about it. Is that right, Gypsy?
Yeah.
Okay, so... We'll tell you the truth. We can't really control any of the films. That comes down to Earth. Cambot, do you have those guys on still store? Okay, let's see that. There's the...
Yeah.
That's the guys who control what films we get. Down on Earth, Dr. Clayton Forrester and Dr. Lawrence Earhart. Now, yeah, I know. Just like at cadet school, they taught us two Gameron movies is ridiculous, but three Gameron movies... is a Gameron Film Festival.
Joel says, when you have lemons, you make lemonade.
Right, we got to make the most of it up here. Anyway, so the film is Gameron versus Gaios, and that is a giant pterodactyl. There is some speculation between Gameron experts that this could be the Baragon from a couple of films back, the giant lizard with the battering ram tongue with wings taped on. You be the judge. We got movie signs. See you on the other side, everybody.
buddy, I'm terrible. Buddy, I'm glad you dropped by. You know why?
Why?
Because today, my friend, you go through puberty.
Puberty? Does that mean I'm going to start perspiring and growing hair in weird places?
No, it just means that I'm getting tired of your voice and it's time to change it, okay?
Will it hurt?
Of course not.
Oh, here it comes, here it comes. Beep! Anything you say, Joel Hodgson, sir, master, giver of all things, good, gracious, host, and friendly neighbor, not a bad cartoonist, governor, liege, lord of all.
I think I'm going to change that algorithm to just master the known world would be better. But anyway, turn around. I got my manual here, and we're going to change your voice. We're going to work on it. Just sing something, okay? And then we can see what happens as the voice changes.
Picture yourself in a boat on a river where palms are in vain and marble
are chipmunk.
Hello, you're on there. Somebody calls you, you answer quite slowly. A girl with colitis, very nice girl indeed.
Somebody calls you, you answer quite slowly. The girl with colitis goodbye, Mr. President. The world as we know it will be ending very soon.
Kissinger, okay, let's try.
Lucy in the sky with diamonds. How? Lucy in Satchmo. The sky with diamonds. Thirsty in the sky with diamonds.
Oh, that's droopy. Or else Carol Channing. Oh, anyway.
Thirsty in the sky with diamonds. Lucy in the sky with diamonds.
Elmer, okay.
Lucy in the sky with diamonds.
Who's that?
Oh,
Ethel Merman. Okay.
Lucy in the... Joel!
What's that?
Joel! Joel, this is great! It's the powerful FM big radio voice I've always dreamed of! Hey, baby, this is Tom Servo calling.
I don't know.
Don't touch me! This is great! It's the great, dynamic, mighty voice, as powerful as the day is long! Come on, Haji, let me keep it.
Okay, but just watch yourself, because one false move and I could just change it at the drop of a hat.
Okay, let me take us to commercial. We'll be right back after these messages. This is Tom
Servo. Oh, you don't want to be like...
I like Tom Servo.
Oh, you don't want to be like Tom Servo. You got a great voice, Gypsy.
I do?
Yeah, it's kind of deep and sexy. I think it reminds me of Kim Carnes.
Kim Carnes, really?
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's kind of what I've been going for all along.
Hey, Cambot, let's show that message that we got and we want to show.
Yeah.
7:34 p.m.
Well, again, we really like the show, but we miss, Servo, Gypsy and Crow. I don't know why you froze Crow. It was a bad idea. Unfreeze Crow. Get Crow out there. Bring Gypsy in. And let's see all three of you commenting on it, because that's even better. What else? Oh, and the American General from earlier in the show, that he was definitely the best character that's ever been on any of the Gamera series. Okay, bye-bye.
Well, we've had a lot of people calling in about where's Crow, and as you know, last week Crow volunteered to be cryogenetically frozen.
Yay, Crow!
To be our Christmas tree here on the Satellite Love. And Cambot, let's show the file tape on that.
I looked up suspended animation in the dictionary, and I don't think that this is going to be any good at all.
See, I told you guys it will work.
Ooh.
Yeah. So, anyway, Crow is frozen. He's beginning to thaw. He'll be out just in time for our New Year's Eve special on Channel 23. Yeah, and it's right after TV23's fabulous Melon Drop, so you want to tune into that, too.
At midnight.
Yeah, what is this?
What? Oh,
well, you took Crow's garland.
No,
I knew
it's
that.
Shiny spaghetti.
No, everything looks like shiny spaghetti to you. We got movie sign. Let's beat it.
8:05 p.m.
Hi, this is a boy that called last week, and I was just wondering if you could come over for my birthday party. It's next week. Here, Sunday. Here, my did I call my mom first? I'll just give my address. And Why don't you come over and bring some of your robots for my birthday? Because I'd really like to have you. Of course, it's okay with you if you can make it. You can come anytime.
That's plenty of Cambot. Anyway, boy who called last week, have a really happy birthday. We can't be there because that's one of the disadvantages of being marooned in space, but have a happy birthday anyway. We decorated the satellite, right, Servo?
Yes.
Got any messages for our boy, birthday boy?
Yes, I do. Remember, little boy, if I can leave you with one birthday message, it is, greet each day with a mighty roar, and I always know what time it is, and wear Old Spice. Walk briskly to and from your job, and remember, neatness counts. Fill your head with candy. You are how you look. Me? I'm a gumball machine. I embrace that, and my colleagues respect me for it. Heed this advice, and maybe, just maybe, you'll grow up to be like me, Tom Servo.
All right, well, you better watch that voice here. You remember what I said. Uh-oh, we got movie sign. Let's beat it!
Yes, then the old ticker on the one.
Well, Servo, so that ends another Gameron film.
Yes, and the old ticker on the wall says it's time to go. But for Joel Hodgson and his robot pals, there would come another day. Gypsy, Joel, Crow, who's frozen, and me, Tom Servo.
Yeah, you know, that reminds me. We won't be on Christmas Day either. TV23 is running some special holiday programming. But to make up for it, we'll be doing a special edition of MST 3000 on New Year's Eve at 12
right
o'clock.
Right you are, Joel Hodgson. Cambot, give it to me one time, buddy boy. Yes, it's a special evening of comedy right here on TV23. First, it's Scott Hansen's freeze-dried comedy special at 10 o'clock, followed at 11 by TV's 23rd annual New Year's Eve extravaganza Golden Jubilee. And then, at the stroke of midnight, it's a special New Year's edition of Mystery Science Theater 3000, an action-packed evening of high-tech hijinks right here on good old KTMA TV23. This has been Tom Servo announcing. Good night and Godspeed.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
I love this voice.
William Conrad narrates
Hey, everybody. Thanks for joining us on the Satellite of Love. It's Mystery Science Theater 3000. I'm here with a frozen crow and Tom Servo over here. Thanks for all your calls. We've had a lot lately about getting crow uncryogeneticized, so stay tuned because that happens today.
Yes, and frankly, I can't wait to see what he thinks of my new dynamic, mighty voice. Let me be the one to greet him from his deep, restful, but all too short of sleep.
Oil can.
Who?
Did you hear something?
Oil can.
Yes, I think it was Crow. He's starting to thaw. I believe he said oil can.
Okay.
Oh, that feels wonderful. I just had the strangest dream, and you, you were all in it, yet you were all somehow different. I had this dream I was frozen and had this strange desire to be flocked and tinseled.
That was no dream, Crow. Hey, Cambot, show him the footage from a couple of weeks back. You'll remember.
Joel, I looked up suspended animation in the dictionary, and I don't think that this is going to be any good at all.
See, I told you guys it would work.
I can't get enough of that.
So it was real. Jeez, help me out of this stuff. I guess the man who made me forgot to give me enough brain to stop him from doing stupid things to me.
Sorry. Hey, come on, Crackle. You were a really good Christmas tree.
Oh.
Yes, and it's a good thing you began to thaw. You know, as we were orbiting over Mexico, there was some conversation about using you as a piñata.
You what?
Nope. No, we wouldn't do that. We were going to unthaw you so you'd be here for the big New Year's celebration.
I was really getting sort of used to being an evergreen.
Really?
Oh, sure. You know, it gets you in the mood to spruce up the place. However, it really made me pine for you all. Oh, come on, fellas. I was just needling you.
Looks like
Crow's back. Uh-oh, we got movie signs. See you in the theater. Let's blow. Welcome to the Satellite of Love. It's a big day up here, isn't it, you guys?
Yes. Absolutely.
Because the guys who hold my destiny in their hands, Dr. Clayton Forrester and Dr. Lawrence Earhart, are about to send me a transmission.
Also, they're the two men who are responsible for marooning you in space.
Yeah, and the two guys who keep sending you those Gameron movies. Whoa!
Come on, you guys. Be nice. It's the new year. It's time to forgive and forget. Besides, they might be sending us news that we're going to be going home. Oh, there's the transmission now. You guys chill out, okay?
Hello, Jolly Boy Toy. Is it true what they say about space?
What's that, sir?
Nobody can hear you laugh.
Happy New Year's, doctors.
Don't Happy New Year me, you white piece of trash floating in the vacuum of space. We just heard that the Russians have launched their own comedian into space, and he's already pulling a 4 rating.
This is my friend Bishi. Bishi, how are you?
I am fine. How is your wife, Bishi? She is fine, but her neck hurts. Thank you so much.
And he's a regular Gallagher, too. It's called Very Incredible Movie Theater 4.
Dr. Earhart and Dr. Forrester, would it be too much to ask if you could let me and my friends know when we might be getting out of space?
Sure, Jolly Polly. We're planning a show for you right now here on Earth.
Really?
Yeah, Booby. It's about a guy and 3 robots, and they're submerged deep in the transatlantic trench, 3 miles under the ocean surface, and we send him transmission after transmission of Jacques Cousteau movies.
What a couple of dickweeds.
Hey, now, Crow, hush up. Listen, thanks, but no thanks, Doc. We'll get used to being out here in space for a little more time.
Excuse me, how long are you going to keep sending us those gosh darn turtle movies?
Don't gosh darn me, you little snack-headed piece of tinfoil. You'll keep watching Gamma movies till we get through all these. Give them a commercial, Clayton.
You're providing a valuable service. Feeling so down. You're providing a valuable service.
Yeah, valuable service to people who watch giant monster movies.
Well, you'd be surprised how many people really like what we're trying to do up here. I'm surprised at you. Who was it who said, when you get lemons, you make lemonade?
Oh, I know I did, but I did mean it in a way, but I kind of just did it because it rhymed with the lyrics when we were writing the beginning theme song. You know, it rhymes with worst movies ever made, have lemons, make lemonade.
Gypsy, say something to cheer Joel up.
I love you, Joel.
I know you do, Gypsy, but I programmed you to say that. It's not the same as it is on Earth when I'm feeling bad.
Now, come on, man.
Oh.
Get a hold of yourself. We've got tons of calls from human beings that say they like it. Cambot, give it to me on the one time. Routine 66 with a blue slate.
8:16 p.m.
What should I say? I don't know. Keep it on the air. It's a great show.
That one didn't sound human. That sounded more like Mr. Ed.
Not well. Now, at least if we know the celebrities are calling. Cambot, give it to me again with the blue slate.
By the way, is this call charging me 50 cents? I certainly hope not.
Oh, is that what they're thinking? No, the calls don't cost 50 cents.
Good
Everybody
job,
should
bro.
Know that.
Well, here's another one.
16 p.m.
Hi, guys. Gypsy, you're gorgeous. Absolutely radiant. I love your show. Your movies are so tacky. I don't know where you get them. It's a good thing that you narrate for me, because otherwise I'd never understand them. Thanks a lot. Keep up the good work. Bye.
See, Gypsy?
Oh.
Everybody thinks you're beautiful. They can all see it.
Oh.
That's great. Let's hear another phone message.
And Gypsy, does he have a speech impediment? I think he should see a doctor pretty soon.
You bet I sounded like Jim Cobb.
I think you do. We have to go talk about it. We'll see you on the other side. It's about one more minute delay from here between us and Earth, but it's about one more minute till the New Year, you guys, okay?
Oh.
Okay, let's hear what your New Year's resolution is going
to
be.
My resolution is to fill my head with good thoughts and good gumballs.
Maybe a Chex party mix?
Perhaps.
Okay.
Yummy.
Bro, what about you?
I just want world peace and my own apartment.
That sounds nice.
And yours, Joel.
Well, I was going to say what he said, world peace and a photon torpedo. That's what I was thinking. Okay, we got 30 seconds. Oh, do you know what Gypsy's is? Anybody?
I don't know.
No? Do you know?
She's not talking to me.
Not, oh, is she still mad about She's that pretty thing? PO'd. Okay, well, we should do the countdown anyway, right?
Ten.
Oh, you want to do it? Tom Servo
announcing. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6.
And 3/4.
5, movie sign.
Oh. We got movie sign. Oh. Happy New Year, everybody. We'll see you in the theater. Yeah. Quick movie review. All right, that's the end of the show, guys. What'd you think of the movie? Let's do a quick movie review.
I like it. I give it a thumbs up.
Thumbs up? You kind of have a claw up.
A claw up.
I laughed. I cried. I cried a lot. It was mediocre at best. I give it a kaka.
What's that? I'm going to have to make your hands movable, and then you can do a thumbs up. I was kind of curious as to how they got all those jet planes. I thought they weren't supposed to have any after the war. You know what I mean? When they had those jet planes
that
were fighting.
Call the UN. Put them on probation.
That's right. They could get in a lot of trouble. Well, next week's show, everybody, is Gamera versus Giron. What is Giron? Does anybody know what a Giron is?
Who cares as long as it's a Gameron movie?
Yeah. Let me check us out, Joel. Okay. Thank you for joining us on Mystery Science Theater 3000.
Good night.
Tom Servo announcing.
No, tonight's film is an encore presentation of Gamera versus Giron.
Ick.
That's not how you say it. It's Giron. It's not a Greek sandwich.
It's Hieron.
Hieron and the Masters of the Puniverse.
It's not a encore presentation. It's a rerun.
Fumnonia.
It's a rerun. Watch it, though, because it's hilarious.
It's just a movie.
It's better than 60 Minutes.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the Satellite of Love. It's Mystery Science Theater 3000, and it's our sixth week in a row showing Gamera films, but we're hoping that we're going to get news from on Earth. The scientists that shot me into space, Earhart and Forrester, are going to give me news otherwise.
You know, Joel, you made us, and it's kind of hard to believe that you just brought us into the world to watch crummy turtle movies.
Yes, with all my parts, I could have made an excellent vacuum cleaner. Instead, it's the movies that suck.
Hey, Crow, now just take it easy. We're going to be online with the scientists any second now, so just take it easy and be polite.
Hello, Jolly Polly guy. I hope you don't mind, but we've taken the liberty of changing the directional coordinates on your ship, and you'll be passing directly through a meteor shower any moment now.
Don't forget to wash behind your ears. Get an ears out, shower. Real funny.
Hilarious.
Hey, Dr. Forrester, Dr. Earhart, how much longer is this Gameron stuff going to go on?
What's the matter, you tan-suited space weenie? You got a problem with poorly acted nonsensical Japanese movies with rubber-suited turtle monkey actors in them?
Listen to me, booby. Turtles are going to be big.
Big!
Really big.
Big!
Now, we've gone through flamingos, Scotty dogs, dinosaurs, and their ilk.
Ilk?
Ilk, yes. Remember those troll dolls and that foam stuff you had as a kid?
Crazy foam.
Yes.
Crazy foam. And Smurfs. And Fuzzy Wuzzy. You know, the soap that grew hair out of it. That was great.
Our soap always had hair on it.
Ooh.
Did you ever take your sister's Barbie doll and go up to the attic and,
Excuse me, sirs?
Don't excuse me, you overinflated skin bag of chemicals and mostly water. Now, listen up. We don't have any more Gameron films for you. So we compiled a list of new movies.
Yes, and unfortunately, it's a pretty good list, too. Let's see, Star Wars, 2001 A Space Odyssey, E.T., Jaws.
Oh, look, Ishtar.
Ishtar?
No, Ish, tar on my shoe.
Wait. Gamera versus Giron, it's perfect.
Ah, Gamera, quick, put it in the deck. I said deck. Put it in the deck. Now listen up, Jolly boy. If you get any more ratings like last week, you're going to be in trouble. Remember, your rocket engines are controlled by ratings. If you don't shape up, you're going to find yourself swimming in the Indian Ocean. Without a paddle. Without a paddle. I got him on the paddle.
Dickweeds. A robot's got to say what a robot has to say. Dickweeds.
Hey, now come on. Hey, we better watch it. Here comes movie sign. Let's get out of here.
Okay, with the...
Okay, with the hydro filter in a vertical position, lift it approximately 1/2 meter from your work surface. Let's see, okay. Okay, gypsum up, periscope. Okay, good job. Let's see. Align flange TDC mark with unit markings. Okay, well, that looks about right. Now hold unit securely with one hand while twisting the cervical collar with the other.
That's it. I love it! Whoa!
Gypsy, what have you done?
Wow, hey, what the... I'm on Earth. This is the control room of those two mad doctors. I wonder what's on the screen.
Hi, I'm Dr. Lawrence Earhart. Please help us. We're trapped in space, please. Welcome to the satellite of Loathe.
I'm Dr. Clayton Forrester. Once again, we've got another movie for you, and... my God.
Oh, no!
Yes, I'm sorry, Lawrence. Once again, we're showing Planet of the Apes Christmas. I wonder if Mr. Crow, in his infinite wisdom and kindness, might send us a different movie this week.
Keep your smock on, you shirt-breathed idiot, or I'll suck all the air out of your ship.
Sorry, Crow Boy.
And no cute names either, you soft-boiled egghead.
Mr. Crow, you forgot to call us dickweeds.
Crow?
Dickweeds.
Crow?
Huh?
Crow, are
what?
You okay?
Oh. Why, I don't know. I was having this strange dream, and Dr. Earhart and Dr. Forrester were in the satellite of love, and only it wasn't, it was the satellite of loathe.
Sure. Yeah, that's okay. That's all right, buddy. We got to go to a commercial now, I think.
The evil robot scientist. I dreamed I was the evil robot scientist, and Dr. Earhart and Dr. Forrester were the ones stuck in space.
You know, that Crow, that's impossible. Robots can't dream.
Yes, we do, Joel Hodgson. I consistently dream about being in a tropical South Sea island with naive native girls fanning me and rubbing me with coconut oil and mango juice all over my little body.
Listen, that's not a dream, Servo. That's a fantasy.
Well, I dreamed I was a hillbilly who was out looking for some food when up through the ground came a bubbling crude. Oil, that is.
Crow, that's not a dream. That's a rerun.
Well, I dreamed that a stupid, young, inexperienced, bumbling senator from Indiana gained access to the White House just because of his rugged good looks.
That's not a dream either, Servo. That's a nightmare.
Boy, this human dream stuff is really difficult to understand.
Oh, we got movie sign. This is when the nightmare begins. See, I don't know. Sometimes, Bob?
Yes, what do you dream about, Joel?
Well, I don't know. Sometimes I dream I'm back down on Earth and walking around looking for fun, feeling groovy. Some days I dream I'm a crane operator. Other times I'm standing in line for Metallica tickets. Then sometimes I dream about Sissy from Family Affair.
Boy, learning to be a human is going to be a tedious affair.
Humans, can't live with them. You can't twist their necks 360 degrees.
Whoa. Take it easy. Take it easy, you guys. Well, what do you dream about, Gypsum?
I dream about you, Joel. Just like you programmed me to.
Oh, brother.
Oh, we got movie silence. It's time to blink. Let's sing the...
I thought those were electric.
No, well, it's on the blink. Let's sing that song.
Satellite of love. Satellite of love. Satellite of love. Satellite of love.
Ow, I feel good. Ow.
Like you,
suck it to me.
Thanks, everybody, for coming in and joining us tonight on Satellite of Love. And let's see, Kent, do your survey, and we'll get the results on that. Kent's working on a survey on Earth for us. And,
new movie next week. New movie.
Yeah, and we got a new movie happening next week, I think, for sure. No more Gamera. I think that ought to do it. Good night, folks.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, but we think we're on the verge of a major... Yes, sir. No, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, I like my... No, I don't like sweeping. Yeah, minimum wage... No, sir. She's a lovely woman. Yes, well, have a nice day, sir. We're kibble, Clay.
Old Leadbottom's onto us, is he?
Yes, he found out we've been siphoning funds from the Project Morpheus.
Project Morpheus? Isn't that where we take the head of a human and splice it onto the body of a dog?
No, that was Project Boreas. Project Morpheus is where you take Minnesota wild rice and keep it from making you go... after you eat it.
Yes. We spent a lot of money shooting Joel into space. How much do we have left?
1 second. Well, I don't think it's enough to bring him down, which is fine, but I think it's enough to call him.
Well, let's get him on the line and reverse the charges.
Hello, jolly boy toy pudding and pie.
Hello, sirs. I'm really excited about the new movie since we're not going to be having any more Gamera films.
Listen, you space pansy, we needed money, so we sold your Dodge.
Not the slant six swinger.
Yeah, booby, we're only about $40,000 short of bringing you back.
No problem.
Well, what about the grant money?
We blew the entire wad customizing the mad scientist mobile.
Hey, I've got $40,000.
You do?
Where?
In my car.
Send him the ant movie.
You know, this is getting to be a lot like Gilligan's Island movie sign! Okay, you guys, we've been on the ship for a while now, and I thought it'd be time I familiarize you with the robotic laws. Do you know what those would be, Crow? You got any ideas?
Well, number one, don't stick anything in your ear larger than a pirate.
You've used that one already.
Oh, right, I'm sorry.
Do you know one, Servo?
Sure. Never hollow out a robot and make a fort out of him.
Oh.
Well, those are both pretty good laws that I think robots should know, but they're not the true robotic laws that Isaac Asimov invented.
Isaac Asimov?
Asimov sounds like a Russian lung disease.
Well, he wasn't a Russian lung disease. He's a great writer. Well, he's not a great writer, but a very prolific writer.
Prolific? I thought he was Russian.
No, anyway, he came up with laws governing robotic action. Do you know what they are?
Come on, Joel. We're robots. We're just joshing you. Of course we know what the robotic laws are. They're burned into our RAM chips.
And you know, there's nothing better than burnt RAM chips and Canadian bacon.
Okay, you smarties, if you're so smart, give me the first robotic law.
No problem. A robot cannot harm a human being.
Okay, and the second robotic law?
A robot cannot, through inaction, cause a human being to come to harm.
And the third?
Give a hoot, don't pollute.
Listen, we'll be right back after this commercial.
Do you like the Catskill thing? Do you like it? We're looking off the ship. What's the first... So, Crow, if we ever get off the ship, what's the first thing you're going to do when we get to Earth?
Well, the first thing I'm going to do is kill Sandy Frank. You know, that guy that keeps importing all those Gamera films?
Well, I think that's a given. I mean, after that.
Empty my load pan. How about you?
Well, I'm going to get me a swinging bachelor pad and invite over a healthy dollop of babes to rub me and fan me and massage me with mango juice and oils and party till 1999. Oh, my God, Joel.
Hi.
Oh, sorry.
What are you guys doing?
We've been wondering, what's the first thing you're going to do when you get back to Earth?
What's the very first thing I'm going to do when I get back to Earth?
No, after that.
Oh, well, I'll probably shut off the water in my apartment.
Huh?
Yeah, I left it running.
So much for your healthy damage deposit.
Yeah, it's pretty much shot. Shouldn't we be going to movie sign after that last joke?
Yes, usually. Perhaps the scientists are a little off. You know, they're a little short on
cash.
Maybe they're selling a child or something.
They could be going door to door selling candy bars like the band always did in high school.
Perhaps. I was wondering about that harming a human thing, Joel.
Uh-huh.
Does it hurt a human to put his hand in warm water while he's sleeping?
No.
Make a note, Crow.
Note taken.
Anyway, Camba, why don't you put up the number on the screen, and please, there it is right now.
623-7655. This is Tom Servo announcing.
Yeah. Sorry. Please call in. We really appreciate your calls, and it's been real helpful. Oh, we got movie sign. Here it is. Let's go.
And I'm Dr. Clayton.
Hi, I'm Dr. Lawrence Earhart.
And I'm Dr. Clayton Forrester.
Pizza.
Pasta.
Pizza.
Pizza and pasta.
Pizza and pasta. Nothing artificial here.
Real cheese. Real meat.
That's the pizza and pasta pledge.
That's right. Our pals at Pizza and Pasta Pizza made this pizza for us so we could eat it at lunch.
Thanks, Pete. Thanks, Paul. Pizza and pasta. Good.
Pretty good pizza and pasta pizza, too.
Pizza.
Yummy noise. You made a yummy noise.
Made a yummy noise.
Because you're hungry.
Okay, you ready?
Yep, your turn.
I spy with my little eye something that starts with the letter C.
Cambot. Oh, too easy. My turn.
I was right there. I thought I might trip.
I spy with my little eye something that begins with the letter B.
Bowling ball?
No, not even warm.
Brace?
Barry Gibb!
On a spaceship? Come on, give me a break.
Bulkhead?
No, good try, cold.
You got any?
Bora Bora?
No, we give up.
Barnacles on the hull of the ship. What? Barnacles from space, you know. Oh, I'm sorry, I had my infrared eyes on.
Why, I oughta.
No fair.
You think that's funny?
Sure.
I blame myself.
Sure. Let's do the song.
What song?
Wipeout. Do it.
Do Wipeout? No.
Do it.
No,
The babes will go wild.
I'll do it. Okay, that's it for another episode of Mystery Science Theater 3000. And we want, Cambot, could you put the number on the screen? We're thinking of creating some demand for a fan club, and we want you to call in and see what you think of it.
If you got the phone, give us a call. 623-7655.
Yes.
Yeah, so, today.
Yeah, so call us at that number.
That number right there.
Right, okay.
Right.
And
today.
We were talking a little bit earlier about that Isaac Asimov's three robotic laws, and I put together a little design circuitry in the robot, a little thing I like to call the fourth robotic law, and now Gypsum and Crow would like to recite it for you. Good night, everybody.
The fourth robotic law by Joel Asimov Hobson.
As read by Crow and Gypsy.
Don't be surprised if somewhere, sometime, when you least expect it, someone walks up to you and says, don't be surprised if somewhere, sometime, when you least expect it, someone walks up to you and says, don't be surprised if somewhere, sometime, when you least expect it, someone walks up to you and says,
these glasses are great. It looked like it was coming right at me.
It was. I just threw it to you, you idiot.
Oh. Clay, let's turn on West Star 5 and look at the game.
Hey, that's a great idea, Larry. Yeah. Oh, but if we turn the transmitter dish, we won't be able to send Joel his weekly diet of movie droppings.
Who cares? No one's watching that weenie anyway. It's Super Bowl Sunday.
Oh, I know. We could use the auxiliary transmitter I bought with the money from the proceeds of those no-D glasses.
These are great. These are kind of kids. I'm so big. Look, I can only see length.
Yes, they're also...
It's a fumble.
Sponsored by the American Association of Eye Doctors and Sandy Duncan.
Sandy Duncan. Let's tune him in. Let's get him.
Come in, Jolene.
Hey, sirs. Boy, your signal's coming in kind of weak today.
Talk about weak. Your ratings couldn't jumpstart a Yugo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jumpstart a Yugo.
Well, I'm just waiting for this week's movie, sir.
Well, my little space tutu, you'll be pleased to know that we're not going to waste another motion picture on you.
Tonight we're going to party like it's 1999.
Yeah. Space 1999.
You mean we're gonna see princes under a cherry moon?
Don't get your hopes up, you human-headed ringball. This is nothing but a poorly acted Martin Landau series from the 70s.
Martin Landau, wasn't he on Mission Impossible?
Yes, and he married Barbara Bain.
Like I said, Mission Impossible.
Oh!
Oh, no!
Say, who do you like in the game today?
Well, I don't know. Probably the Niners.
Niners, yeah. I got my money on Cincy. Say, did you see Carson last night?
Yeah.
How do you like that new guy? You know, that...
You mean Jay Leno?
No, you know, that new guy, that black Carson.
Oh, Arsenio Hall.
Yeah, that's him. Yeah, he's pretty good. Oops, was that your ear?
No,
Oh. How about this?
Ow!
Oh, sorry. Little barber joke there. Oh, hey, say, what do you want me to do with this cyst?
Shave around it.
Oh, okay. Gypsy, get me the tongs. Say, could you put your finger right there? Yeah. It looks like we're going to commercial. I want to remember where I was. Let's see. I'm going to go get some hot towels. See you in a bit.
Hey, let's get Gypsy.
I'm not going to try it.
Hey, let's get Gypsy.
Yeah.
She'll try anything.
Nah, she's too heavy. She'd fall through the bulkhead.
Okay, here I go.
Good.
Sorry, but, I lost my head.
Next time, come out of your tuck. Oh, my God! Oh, no! It's horrible! Oh!
Joel, get my head!
Oh, it's
this
disgusting.
This is embarrassing, Joel.
Oh, disgusting.
Get my head.
What are you guys doing?
Well, we were reading Darwin, and we got to thinking. It says that species evolve out of necessity over a period of time.
We were just helping the process
That's
out a little.
That's a lot better, thank you.
We thought we could just, keep jumping until we missed the floor, and then we'd be flying.
But you guys can't evolve your machines. The only way you could change is if I outfit you with more sophisticated gear.
We're just trying to be human, and it's kind of hard without a head. Thank you.
I know, but you guys should know that you're not judged by your molecular structure, but how well your characters evolve.
You mean this is a feel-good segment?
We're starting to do Cosby on Mystery Science.
Hey, Servo, tell me again about those mango juice rubbing babes.
Well, there was Monday and...
I get it.
I lost my head again.
Well, remind me to never let the robots write another segment. We got movie science!
Idiot.
Now it looks...
Hey, we can jump off the table and fly. I look like an idiot.
No, it looks good. You can hardly tell.
The babes won't go wild anymore.
Besides, medical expenses are tax deductible.
Deductible, okay.
Let's see. Line 19, moving expenses. You can take this deduction if you moved in connection with your job or business and your change in job location has added at least 35 miles to the distance from your old home or your workplace. Let's see. Servo, is this more than 35 miles?
Horizontal or vertical? Say yes, really sure. Yes, it's more,
I
guess.
Yeah, I'll put yes down, yes.
Yes.
Okay. If you begin work in a new workplace outside the United States, get form 3903F. Oh, well, it looks like another trip to the post office.
Roger, I'd like to see him try to audit us.
Let's see. Add totals of line 19 through 11 and put the result on line 22G. Oh, boy, no wonder Joel has us doing his taxes. I've never done something this taxing in all my life.
What does it say there? Well, he's claiming three robots as business expenses?
Business expenses? Boy, it's nice to know that you're appreciated.
Oh, Jesus.
Hey, you guys, how's it going on my 10W40?
Well, so-so.
We're not doing too badly for a couple of deductions.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, now that we are officially business expenses, perhaps we should be wearing ties around here and demanding maintenance contracts.
Oh, you guys don't understand. The government makes me claim you guys as deductions. I have to because you don't have Social Security numbers.
But Joel, we are dependents. We depend on your bad movies.
Yeah, and we depend on your lame jokes, too.
Hey, you guys can't take it so personally. I have to claim you guys that way or else they'd throw me in jail.
At least you'd be off the satellite.
Oh, it's a movie! It's a movie! No! You're going to hike me the ball. You're the... Okay, now, you guys. We're going to do this one. It's the economy six play, okay? Now, Gypsy, you're going to hike me the ball. You're the center. Now, give me some protection on the line. They're killing me back there, okay? You go along, do a post, okay?
Right.
39! 29! Hike!
Hey!
Go on! Good! Hey!
Hey! I'm like the fridge!
We are the champions!
I'm the fridge! I'm the fridge!
And we'll go on fighting till the end!
We are the champions!
We are the champions! No time for losers, but don't forget to call us, because we are the...
Hey, look, our number, 623-7655, Dr. Culligan, yeah. Call.
Wait, kick me in the head. Tackle! Tickle monster.
Coming up, there's a new...
Is it working for you?
Shh.
Oh, we're off. Did you see the ratings from last week's show? They went up.
Against the Super Bowl. I don't get it. The hot levels were out of this world, too. We gotta send him something really awful this week. What do you have?
Well, I'd like to shake hands with the man who can think his way around this film. It's another Sandy Frank epic, this time from Czechoslovakia. Even Jolie's mother couldn't watch this thing.
Let's see what the boy wonder is up to.
Good idea. Hello, Joel the Mole.
Hello, sirs. Hey, great movie last week, huh? You know, I don't think a lot of people realize this, but it wasn't really a movie. It was just two Space 1999 segments edited together.
Regardless of what it was, it put your ratings through the ceiling.
Even you could have beaten the Cincinnati Bengals. And I'm on $50.
Hey, maybe they'll give me MVP.
Don't get cocky with me, you orbiting Wilford Brimley wannabe.
Joe, do the words oxygen deprivation mean anything to you? Look, if your ratings keep going up, we're going to be forced to send you...
Jeez, you guys, last week the ratings were low and you got mad.
Hey, we're mad scientists. What do you expect? Larry, put in humanoid women.
Move aside!
Dag, you're it.
Hey, come here, you guys. Come on in here, everybody. We got movie sign.
Movie sign?
Come on, get in here.
Sorry. Movie sign.
We got movie sign. Hey, Servo, you're it. Psych!
Macho guy. Macho robots. There's no question I'm a macho guy. Hey. Whoa, excuse me, miss. Say, I've never noticed you on the satellite before. I'm Tom Servo, man about satellite. Sure, I may look small, but I'm built like a Cuisinart, really. You know, don't think me forward, miss, but I couldn't help but notice that you've got 11 settings. You know, you're kind of quiet, and I like that in a woman. Too many of the gals I've known just like to rub exotic oils on me and fan me, which is okay, I guess, but I need a change.
I need a woman more my speed, and I happen to notice you've got 11 of them. Wait, I must have offended you. You're blushing. No, that's juice, I think. You know, I've always found juice in the head to be quite a turn-on. My little scientific calculator, you. Ever gotten a wild hair and just filled your head with guacamole for the hell of it? I'm the kind of robot who likes to throw caution to the wind, if you know what I mean. And if you do, will you please tell me? Hey, I see you've still got a power cord. An old-fashioned gal. I like that. I like a good tail on a woman. Pardon me, I know I might be coming on a little bit strong, but I love your lines. You've got classic features. Crush, grate, chop, puree. Baby, you've got it all. And a lovely singing voice, too. Baby, you do got it all. Joel, I'm in love.
What do you mean, Servo?
Joel. My God, man, you've defiled my honor. Nobody drinks from my gal. The gauntlet's been thrown.
Hey, Servo, it's a blender.
Oh. Excuse me, miss. You know, you've got beautiful... Oh, excuse me, Mr. Coffee. I'm so embarrassed.
Hey, great job. Hey, great job, Cambot. That looks good. I want to thank Cambot for turning us upside down for this special tribute to Salvador Dali.
You know, Joel, what was your first experience with surrealism?
Well, I think it would have to be Servo. Back when I was on Earth and I was a little boy in first grade, the Monkees TV show, they had those dream sequences. They were pretty surreal.
I like those Dali watches. You know, they take a licking and keep on dripping.
You want surreal? I'll give you surreal. A very Brady Christmas. Just watching little Cindy age. I don't know. Didn't she get killed in Vietnam or something?
You know, I don't like the way this segment is going. Luckily, we got movie stars!
Look out!
All the people have called.
I'm such a macho guy.
Thanks for all your calls. All the people have called in. We really appreciate it.
You know, Joel?
Yeah?
Were you ever a big Village People fan?
Me? No, just for about half a second, and then I realized what was going on.
You know, I was reading an article, kind of one of those Where Are They Today articles.
Uh-huh.
I read that, you know, one of them's a construction worker now, one of them's a Indian, one of them's a cowboy out in Montana, and one of them's a police officer. Work with me here.
That's justice.
It is.
Yeah. What about you, Crow? What are you going to do while the show's not on this week?
Well, I'm going to get some things done around the satellite, you know, some maintenance work that I've been wanting to catch up on. No, not that exciting, but, you know, that's kind of, you know, I'm kind of happy.
And the people calling, we really don't have any control over what movies come in, so quit trying to tell us what to do on those calls, all right?
Unless you're friendly about it.
Yeah. We really can't control it. But I guess that's it.
How about a big dating game kiss?
Okay. Fuck.
Well, granted, you're the only one who has arms.
Did they fix that in post-production?
I've never seen Dating Game.
Talk to Joel, 6237655. This is Tom Servo saying goodbye, and God like you.
Hi, Las Vegas Caesars? Yeah, room 666, please. Clay, it's Lair. How's Vegas? Yeah. How's everything at the Mad Scientist Convention? You're sharing a room with Bruno and the Creeper? Is he still eating bugs? He what? In the hot tub? Lipton? I guess that's how you handle hungry, man. Yeah, right, or whatever he is. So what have you seen so far? Really? What did she do? She's the star of La Cage aux Folles? Clay, wait a second. I was in La Cage aux Folles in high school. I was a star. You gotta call it off, Clay. They're all boys. Yeah, boys. B-O-Y. Yep. Let me lay it out for you. I'm really glad you found a new friend, but you're dating a guy. No, you gotta call it off. No, I won't hold it against you as long as he doesn't hold it against you. Okay, yeah. Okay, well, what about the money? Okay, when you're at the roulette table, remember the system. Joel, well, he's fine. He has at least another week of oxygen left. Okay, look, I just got the findings out of the computer. Put half of the research grant on red and take the other half and bet on video dog racing. You can't miss, I swear. Okay, okay. Give my love to Siegfried and Roy. I'm kidding. It's a joke.
Okay, we'll see. Okay, don't forget to punch holes in the suitcase or that cat will die. Okay, bye-bye. Bye-bye. Hey, Joel.
I miss my friends and family. Get me down.
Dr. Forrester is appealing to the, committee as we speak to get some more funding. By the way, tell Servo I've got a delightful Presto salad shooter that's just dying to meet him.
There's an important moniker which I learned from my friend Crow. I believe it's Dickweed.
Well, everybody, the movie that's coming up next is called Fugitive Alien. Fugitive Alien. Anyway, Fugitive Alien, and you know it's kind of got to be bad if they just take two cool words and put them together like that.
Like Mystery Science?
Well, I'd like to sing the theme now to Fugitive Alien. He's a fugitive and he's gone away. Fugitive alien every day.
Hey.
Fugitive will make you free. Fugitive. Fugitive.
Joel, you're hurting my spine.
Movie set, let's go! Servo, have you seen... Hey, Servo, have you seen Crow?
Crow? I don't know anybody named Crow. Crow who?
Yeah, Crow that, Crow that gold robot that you share a bunk
gold
with?
Gold robot? I recognize the name, but I can't place the stupid, unbearable face.
Come on, Crow. Servo, I know you know who Crow is. Now, would you please tell me where he is?
Oh, Crow! That Crow! he's on the... let me consult my RAM memory. Oh, yes, here it is. He's on the roof repairing the C-band antenna. Yes, the C-band.
Crow, there's nothing wrong with the C-band antenna.
Did I say C-band? I meant he's on the spiral on down wearing his Ray-Bans.
Listen, Servo, you're keeping the truth from me. If you don't tell me where Crow is, I'm going to give you a voice like Punky Brewster.
Punky? The babes will never go for that. No way. Hey, where do you want his head, Servo? Ixnay on the Ed Hay, Ipsy J.
What are you guys doing taking Crow's body apart? What were you thinking?
Well, Gypsy, we might as well tell him. The cat's out of the bag. We were trying to install a hot air popper in Crow for your birthday.
Listen, I don't believe you. I want you to reassemble him as soon as you can.
Come on, let's go back. His thorax didn't make a very good seal a meal anyway. I just hope we can find his spine.
Commercial set! It's more like the same reason you never...
Stage with Michael Jackson is what you're saying.
Well, it's more like the same reason you never see, Jim Backus and Richard Nixon together.
Oh, I get it. You never see Fred Flintstone and Tip O'Neill sucking back brewskis in the Bedrock Tavern together.
Right, unless the Wayouts are playing, then it's possible.
There's a town I know where the hipsters go called Bedrock. Twitch.
It's probably the same reason why you never see a Lions Club gumball machine and you together.
Hey, wait a minute. I resemble that.
Movie side! Do a thing that they do on Earth. All right, now, you guys. We're going to do a thing that they do on Earth called... It's a dance contest like Hullabaloo. And you guys are going to dance and move to the music. And then I'm going to be Dick Clark and rate you, okay? Let's go!
Boy, is this going to be fun.
Come on, let's move it. Shake it.
Gentlemen, there's no need to feel down. I said, young man, pick yourself off the ground.
Okay, that's good. Okay, that's good.
I can't stop the music. I've got it in me, Joel. It's all...
Oh. You're like Kiki D. Okay, now turn around.
Sorry, Joel.
Now, did you like that segment?
It's really pretty the stupidest one we've done, I think. It's pretty poor. But, you know, I'm really not used to dancing without my usual harem of babes fanning me and rubbing me in mango juice and oils and... Oh.
All right, well, just settle down because it's time for me to rate you, okay? I took that into account, and that's why you get a 1 for originality, a 2 for appearance,
and
1 for a lip sync.
Oh, an average score of 1 to the 3rd, not bad, I guess. I would like to say hi to my girlfriend Debbie, though. Hey, Debbie, you know what I mean.
See you later, Doc.
Okay, now it's your turn, Gypsy.
Yay!
Okay, let's see. You get a 3 for imagination.
3.
A 3 for originality.
3.
And a 0 for lip sync.
But I thought it was a dance contest.
Yeah, I know. I forgot to tell you. But anyway, you're our new winner.
Yay.
With an average score of 2. Drum roll, please.
I would like to thank my mom for sending me to dance lessons and for Joel for installing a hydraulic pressure well.
Yay! Okay, that'll do it.
You're a goddess of dance. Oh, really?
Oh, all right, keep your feet on the ground. We gotta go to movie sign. So many people. Did I scare you? Anyway, we've had so many people call in and say they wanted to have a fan club. We're gonna try to have one. What I want you to do is send us a postcard. And Canbot, could you put it up on a CG up on the screen, heavy on the 30 weight? There it is. You want to say it?
That's right. Send your postcard with your name and address to Mystery Science Theater 3000, care of TV23, 2505 Kennedy Street Northeast, Minneapolis, Minnesota 55413. Be sure to include your favorite soup.
Do you remember the address to the Spiegel catalog, the zip code? Spiegel catalog 5050-60609.
That spells speak, doesn't it, on the phone?
I don't know. Anyway, thanks for the cards and leathers. And
leathers. All the fine leathers you've sent us.
And call us.
623-7655. Talk to the crew of Mystery Science Theater 3000. We'd love to hear from you.
And then that's it. And everything will be okay.
Come on, Haji, we're out of here. Buck up, little buddy. Let's go.
All right.
Experiment hurls two sailors forward.
Has been actors.
Put them in a TV film.
Put them in a fiery crash.
Hey, Robert Reed and Burgess Meredith.
Not the dad from Brady Bunch.
Yes, he is. In a fiery death scene.
Marty Milner, too.
I don't want to talk about it.
Come on, Clay. You've been brooding ever since you got back from Vegas. You gotta tell me what happened. Listen, Clay, I'm your friend. More than that, I'm your partner. And more than that, I'm your doctor. And if you don't tell me, time for the physical.
You're right, Larry. I don't know how I can keep this from you. Look in the briefcase.
Oh, my God!
Sacks and sacks of money. I want it playing Keno. He knows my game. What can I tell you? I don't know. I tried everything to lose. I tried closing my eyes and making little X's on the paper, and everything I did worked. I'm charmed. What can I tell you?
There are hundreds.
I know. It's like that episode of Andy Griffith when Aunt Bee went to Las Vegas and put the chip down on the roulette wheel and kept on winning. And, Larry, it gets worse.
Worse?
There's more in the car.
In the mad scientist mobile?
No, the Austin.
The Austin?
Yeah, I bought it to bring the money back. I bought you one, too.
Oh, thank you.
Cheers. Thought I'd weigh that down with money, too. Traction, you know.
Good idea. You know what? We're not only mad, we're rich. We're filthy rich. We can do really cool stuff now. We can build a giant laser or knock the Earth off its axis or we can bail out Midwest Federal.
Wow. Think of all the appliances and stadium blankets we can get. Oh, speaking of getting things, I brought you something back.
Little, I can't get over you.
Little trinket, little Chotsky.
You've really changed for the better. Something really must have changed you in Vegas.
Yes, it's the Isaac Asimov body splash. It's
part
of the Foundation Trilogy gift set. See? Take a whiff.
Oh, smells pretty. Like space. Starts bold, finishes clean.
Yeah, it was this or the iRobot grooming bikini waxing set.
Good call.
Oh, and something else. Mad scientist masculine hygiene mist.
Let me try.
Later.
I'm overwhelmed. You really are something special.
Oh, no, you're something special, Lair. Did a lot of thinking about you when I was in Vegas. And I brought back a super film.
Really?
Yes. It's called SST Death Flight.
It's perfect for Joel. He'll love it. The death light thing. It ties in great.
You're right. I didn't think of that before. It's got Lauren Green and Bert Convy.
It's 2 hours long, but to Lauren Green, that's like 98.
I was leaving the parking lot in Caesar's Palace, and I ran into Bert Convy, and he gave me the film. So why don't we send it up?
Let's do it.
Okay.
$100 says you do it.
Oh, no. Here's 200. You push the button.
All right, okay.
Move inside!
Everything's set up good. Okay, everything's set up good.
Mm-hmm.
You ready to let her loose, Crow?
Ready to rip. Thanks for making me the control group. Now, as for servo, how many volts do you feel like today?
Crank it up. I can take it. I won't talk, though. You can fill my head with gummy bears and I won't talk. This reminds me of when I was in Guam.
Now, servo, everybody knows that robots cannot feel pain. This is a little experiment to simulate that for you, since you want to know what it's like to be a human. This first setting that we've got is going to feel like what it's like to get stub your toe. Go ahead, Crow.
Okay.
Ouch.
Okay, this next setting is the equivalent of experiencing a fiery Yugo crash. Go ahead, Crow.
Ouch. Oh, hurt me. I'll never talk. Don't you get it? Is this the best you can do, Mr. Salty?
I say we take him to the top floor and drop him. Let's take it to the Arsenio setting.
Yeah, and besides that, he called me Mr. Salty, whatever that means. All right, this next setting, servo, is going to be the equivalent of watching an hour of Arsenio Hall with guests Brooke Shields, Jackie Collins, and a curator from the Milwaukee Zoo.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Yeah.
I gotta talk. Oh, golly.
Gal, I better unhook you here.
I love the smell of burning ram chips in the morning. It smells like victory.
Well, thanks a lot, sir. Well, at least we found out what you can handle.
Hey, Crow, no hard feelings. Let's shake on it. That was the Morton Downey Jr. setting, butthead.
Commercial.
What? You know,
Better from what?
You know, my cold.
I didn't know you had a cold. Your voice is different. I programmed it to be that way. I wanted it deep and sexy, kind of like Kim Carnes, but I kind of botched it at the end.
Well, now you know. I have a great voice. I can sing, too. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Mr. President. Happy birthday to you.
You know, I'm really amazed. I don't know how that happened.
Oh, my God. For being my creator, you sure are gullible. I was throwing my voice. Did you see my lips move?
No, you don't really have lips, but I think I know what you mean.
You kill me, doll. We fooled you good. What a chair leg. Yeah, you're a bubble and a half off plum. The lights are on, but nobody's home. Yeah, the factory's there, but they're making something else now.
Movie star!
Daylight come and me one go home. Day-o, day-o. Daylight come and me one go home. Come Mr. Tallyman, telly me banana. Daylight come and me one go home. Come Mr. Tallyman, telly me banana. Daylight come and me one go home. A beautiful bunch, a ripe banana. Daylight come and me wanna go home. It's highly deadly, black tarantula. Daylight come and me wanna go home. Sing Bruce Watson and Mark Anderson of Richfield. Hey! Come, Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana. Sing Mark Utari of Zimmerman. You wanna go home. Day-o. Me said day, me said day, me said day, me said day, oh.
We theater fan club, we really...
Okay.
Thanks, everybody who's written in for the Mystery Science Theater fan club. We really appreciate it.
Joel, read the ones from the babes, the female call.
Yeah. Okay, Canva, put that one up on the screen. Go ahead, servo.
Hello, howdy, fellas. All of us girls absolutely die for you. When 6 p.m. Sunday rolls around, we drop everything to watch your show. Mystery Science Theater is choice entertainment, and it goes on to say Servo is the most incredible creation ever made, and we want him badly.
Hey, Cambot, put that cool one up.
Cambot?
Cambot.
Says, Dear Joel, think your show is great. I watch it all the time. I like the one when a lady was sitting in a chair covered with a blanket and Crow said, Hey, nice jammies. All you guys are funnies. That's from our pal Andy Kalinowski, North Minneapolis.
Yeah, so
a nice photo of you there, Joel.
Thanks. Looks well, anyway, really keep those cards and letters coming in. And that address again, Servo, read it, buddy.
Mystery Science Theater 3000 Fan Club, care of TV23, 2505 Kennedy Street Northeast, Minneapolis, Minnesota, 55413. Please write soon and send us the name of your favorite pizza topping.
I think you're going to be sorry you said that. Anyway, we'll see you next week. Thanks a lot.
Bye. Wittingly becomes the pawn of a federal...
We've got to talk.
I'm done talking. I'm all talked out. What's wrong with you anyway?
I'll change.
Well, then change, damn you.
I've changed.
Not that quickly. It doesn't count.
You've got to stop it. It doesn't make sense. You're killing us, Clay. We're not mad scientists. We're just angry.
Forget it. It will cost too much to change the letterhead. My God, I wake up this morning, I've got a mad scientist for a partner, and now you've turned into Florence Henderson.
Oh, and is that so wrong? We need a change. New outfits, a splash of color, maybe.
Sorry to interrupt you two, but are we still doing this movie thing or what?
How long have you been listening?
Oh, since Thursday.
My casserole!
Oh, right, the movie. It's Mighty Jack.
But Larry... Movie Soto!
Well, what are we going to tell him this time?
We don't have to tell him anything. He'll just laugh. The book says he'll just laugh.
Who's gonna tell him?
Well, it's between you and me. We welded Gypsy's lips together and Servo, as long as your hand is gonna be welded there, you might as well give me a scratch.
Oh. You know, maybe we should stand by the heat exchange ducts and we can try to blend in.
You know, I've got a funny urge to apply for an arts board grant.
What are you
What
are you guys doing? You're all welded together. You kind of look like a microbrewery.
It's a little something we learned in the Boys' Life book of safe but naughty practical jokes. And our shadow kind of looks like a Chinese dragon. Do you think it works?
No.
Do you think it's funny?
Mm-mm. Nope.
Well, what do you think is funny?
Well, I think it'd be funny if you were all welded together and then were wearing women's foundation garments.
Oh.
Good
idea.
Now that's funny.
Funny, but uncomfortable.
Not me. I'm wearing the teddy.
Let's go to a commercial. I feel like Benny Hill.
Oh. Oh. Punky Brewster, does anybody think this is funny?
Now the robot on Lost in Space, now that was funny. Danger, Will Robinson, danger.
Now that was funny.
Well, of course it was funny. That was a great line.
Well, he had great writers.
Let's face it, we don't know what humans think is funny.
You're right. Take Joel, for example. Last week, he thought sending electrical charges through me was funny.
Now he thinks that wearing women's clothing is funny.
You know, maybe it's time to destroy him.
Nah.
No, it's fatal for humans. There's no reboot system. And get this, no backup copy.
No backup copy?
Now that's funny. Danger, danger, Will Robinson. Oh, danger, danger, danger.
Oh, I love that bit.
Oh, movie time. Danger, Will Robinson.
Oh, 7-10 split. That's going to be hard to beat.
Here we are at the fifth frame. Crow is staring at a nasty 7-10 split for the Intersatellite Championship.
Good hook. It's a good looking good. It is.
Bingo.
All right.
Oh, that puts me over a 90.
Good shot.
Oh, boy, I hate these rental shoes, though.
Oh.
No matter how much you spray in, they still smell funny.
Shh.
Wait a minute, I didn't know you could smell.
Ixnay.
Did I say smell? I meant spectral analysis, of course.
Hey, let's play murder ball now.
No.
No? Hey, I created you guys. I invented your world, and when I say I want to play murder ball, we play murder ball.
Okay, not it.
Not it.
Wait a minute, do over.
Not it.
Not it.
Not it. How about, I know, let's play rock, scissors, paper with Crow.
No way.
Great thing.
No, I'm never going to play that with you. Look at my hand. See? I can only be scissors and you get rock all the time.
Well, it's the luck of the draw, you know?
Okay, you win everything.
Bye, Joel. See you later. Why don't you go home to your mom? I'm your friend. Not.
Come on, let's ditch him, dweeb.
Hey, thanks for creating me, Joel. Next time, no free will. Movie sign. And that means it's time for the viewer. Hi, everybody. It's our last segment, and that means it's time for the viewer mail. And why don't you read yours first, Crow?
Okay.
Put it up on the screen cam.
Says, Dear Joel and robots, I really like your show, especially the movie that was called Death Flight. The funny part was when Servo says, his eye needs some air. I laughed as hard as I could. I think your robots are the best creation in the world, especially Servo.
I like it.
Must
good
be a chance. Typo, I think.
I think it's handwritten.
P.S., you're all neat. Cool drawing, too. Great.
Yeah, and I got one here, and Kamba put that one up. It's a drawing of Crow.
Yay!
So. Yeah, and this one says, Hey, Joel, Gypsy, Servo, and Crow. I think your show is great and very cool. Lately, I have been worried about Servo. He seems to be empty-headed, and you might do something to fill his head with good thoughts. What do you think of that?
He could write me more fan letters, and I would create plenty of good thoughts.
Okay,
nice
Crow, I think that you are the best, even though you look like a metal baseball glove with eyes.
I don't see that. No, I don't.
With
I don't
my
know
letter, I have enclosed a picture of Crow because he is so cool.
He's wrong. Yes. You look like a golf bag with eyes.
Right. Okay. And
that's Mr. Golf Bag to you, buddy.
And it's time for yours now, too.
Tom Servo's female call.
Put it
just
up,
this letter is. It's a lovely letter.
Oh, we got a picture in it.
This young lady here is madly in love with you, and her friend, Mike, wrote to you and says and tells you that she likes you. And
let's
I
see
quote
the letter,
from
Cambot.
I quote from the letter. Although this girl is only in high school, you will find that she is a magnificent pagan she-beast. I'm liking it. I'm liking it a lot. Her name is Amy, and you can write her at my address. It's okay. Wonderful, isn't it?
Okay, here's the information for the fan club. Keep those cards and letters coming.
Join the few, the proud, the elite. Join the Mystery Science Theater 3000 fan club. Care of TV 23, 2505 Kennedy Street Northeast, Minneapolis, Minnesota, 55413.
Good. All right, and her picture stays right on the set. You see that? How we got that?
Yep.
Anyway, see you later, folks. Thanks a lot.
Dear Uncle Wally, well, it's been nearly a third of a year since Joel invented me, and wait a minute. That's right, Joel invented me. My experiences are simulated. I don't even have an Uncle Wally. Dear to whom it may concern, well, it's been nearly 4 months since Joel invented me, and even though he didn't give me working arms, luckily I can type with my feet. I thought it was about time to write and let you know how things have been hanging here on the satellite of love. Looking forward to my first trip to Earth, let's face it, dehydrated mango juice just isn't the same, especially when you have to rub it on yourself. But I have to face facts. A trip to Earth is a long way down the line. Just yesterday, we were talking to the evil scientist who trapped us here, and I was surprised to find out that...
You're right, Servo. We never looked at it that way.
You know, that little bucket of diodes is really onto something.
Yes, and as you can see, it'd be completely to your benefit to bring us back to Earth. Sure, you'd have that airheaded white guy smiling up the place, but look at the bright side. You'd also have me and my ever-present bevy of babes at your side. We could do the carnival circuit.
He's right, and with Servo's artificial intelligence, we could...
We could do the ventriloquist act without ever moving our lips.
That's right. Great idea. Servo, tell the guys to be ready to return to Earth at 12 p.m. tomorrow.
Hi, Servo.
Hello.
Oh, hello, dickweed. Hey, Earhart, is that your head or did your neck blow a bubble?
Why, you little...
And Forrester, I saw you with your date last night. She had lovely hoofs.
Now, just a minute.
Cool it, Crow. You're blowing it.
It's all off, Servo. Your little golden buddy blew it for you.
That's right. And you can expect a boring football movie to boot. And it stars, among other non-talent actors, Dick Butkus.
Butkus.
As you can see, I am surrounded by incompetence, gentle readers. Oh, well. In the words of the mortal Joel Hodgson, movie sign! It can be hard up here on the satellite of love. Why, just the other day, I thought Joel had blown a ram chip for sure. For some reason, he hooked me up to a voltage generator and was running current through my shell. Well, I played along with his little jaunt into sadism, but I don't know how long that really I can really take this anymore.
Hey, everything's set up good.
Mm-hmm.
You ready to let her loose, Crow?
Ready to rip. Thanks for making me the control group. Now, as for Servo, how many volts do you feel like today?
Bring it up. I can take it. I won't talk, though. You can fill my head with gummy bears, and I won't talk. This reminds me of when I was in Guam.
Now, Servo, everybody knows that robots cannot feel pain. This is a little experiment to simulate that for you, since you want to know what it's like to be a human. This first setting that we've got is going to feel like what it's like to get stub your toe. Go ahead, Crow.
Okay.
Ouch.
Okay, this next setting is the equivalent of experiencing a fiery Yugo crash. Go ahead, Crow.
Ouch. Oh, hurt me. I'll never talk. Don't you get it? Is this the best you can do, Mr. Salty?
I say we take him to the top floor and drop him. Let's take it to the Arsenio setting.
Yeah, and besides that, he called me Mr. Salty, whatever that means. All right, this next setting, Servo, is going to be the equivalent of watching an hour of Arsenio Hall with guests Brooke Shields, Jackie Collins, and a curator from the Milwaukee Zoo.
Yeah.
Go ahead,
yeah.
I'm gonna talk. Oh, golly.
Gal, I better unhook you here.
I love the smell of burning ram chips in the morning. It smells like victory.
Well, thanks a lot, Servo. At least we found out what you can handle.
Hey, Crow, no hard feelings. Let's shake on it. Talk about the decline and fall of Western civilization. I just have to keep reminding myself that he's just a human, and he's got the key to the lubricant cabinet. Oh, well. Commercial side, this is Tom Servo announcing. Crow and Joel and Gypsy, not so bad to live with. Just a bunch of fun-loving guys locked in a decaying orbit with nothing to do but watch terrible films. Funny thing is, Joel's lovable on-air persona is nothing like his day-to-day demeanor. Like yesterday, after recharge, Joel sat us down for his weekly attitude talks. And boy, was he a little miffed.
Hey, Gypsy, there's your drivetrain. It's a wonder you're even moving. You left it on the shower rod.
Huh? What?
Listen, just because you have to have your oil changed every week doesn't mean you own that shower.
Okay.
Now, you, Crow.
Uh-oh, here comes the prod.
You left your load pan out. After recharge, you know the rule.
Well, it was Servo's turn to take...
I told you, I'm not doing your load.
Listen, I'm not normally this way. It's just Servo's perception of me.
Boy, you're really crabby.
You're next, Servo.
What?
I found gum underneath all of the theater seats.
How do you know it was mine?
It was Juicy Fruit.
Okay, it was mine. But you'll never take me alive, Copper. Stop it a while, Ma. I could have been a contender. Stella!
I woke up. You weren't there. I hate that. I'm not going to be ignored, am I?
Mary, don't you know me?
Rosebud.
Listen, Crow, I want you to clean that up. I'm going to be in my trailer.
You know, Gyps, the problems of two little people don't amount to a hill of beans in this crazy world. All I know is you're going to get on that plane. No matter what happens between you and me, well, we'll always have Paris.
Paris?
Paris. Well, here's looking at you, kid. This could be the start of a beautiful friendship. Friendship. Friendship.
So, Kitty, mein lieber Schatz, I leave you now, for I mustn't get in on Kino sign! Perhaps I've been a little bit hard on my orbiting compatriots. Joel's really okay, and so is Gypsy and Cambot, and... Well, you know, I really love Crow, too, though I'd never tell him. If you really want to know, we've had some great times here on the Satellite of Love, too. Quality times. Kind of times which only come around once in a lifetime. The kind of times you only see in a videotape montage piece.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white. The bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Color of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky.
Hey, Servo, come on, it's almost movie sign.
What do you mean, movie sign? We're supposed to hit credits now. It was a beautiful moment, television magic. Oh, man, you mean there's more movie?
We got movie sign, let's go.
I felt tears out there, Joel. You'll see, you'll get letters.
Clay, did you see this? We got a letter from the Mad Scientist League. They say they were going to revoke our licenses, that we're not really mad enough.
I know. Look, it says here, at best, we're mildly peeved researchers.
Researchers? Ooh. That hurts. I haven't been in research since I was at the U doing kitchen cabinet analysis for Ken Keller's house.
Well, what about those 2 years at the Pentagon?
Well, it was 2 weeks, really. I got paid for 2 years. It's a good gig.
Mildly peeved researchers. You know what this means, don't you?
We'll have to change our name tags?
Well, no. It means no more fat research grant, no more large funded laboratory, and no more Jolie and the robots.
Well, that's not necessarily such a bad thing.
Well, maybe, but consider this. We'll have to go back to work in the private sector.
No, not back to fruit inspection.
I'm afraid so. You know, we can't make it by on cuteness alone. You know, we're not mild-mannered matinee hosts. We're mad scientists, damn it!
Well, it's not our fault, though. Look at the movies. You know, Superdome, SST Death Flight, what's this week's City on Fire? It's not our fault. Where's the science?
Well, the science comes in taking a group of grade B actors, sticking them in a overproduced, horribly written, made-for-TV disaster film, which happens to be a vehicle for Barry Newman, and packaging the thing and sending it out to the common man and making millions of dollars off of it. It's kind of like giving cancer to lab rats.
I don't really follow.
Well, here, let's go watch the movie, City on Fire, and I think you'll get my point.
All right.
This is perfect. I love it. This is great.
Jeez, it. Here he comes.
Hey, I just got this month's actuals, you guys, off the computer, and we're way over on WD-40. Somebody's been abusing their privileges. I think we're going to have to cut back.
Hey, let me look now, Servo. It's my turn. Let me
look. No way. Wow. She's fabulous.
What are you looking at, Servo?
Fabulous Russian cosmonaut babes over at Salyut 7, and they haven't drawn their shades.
Wait a minute. Let me look at
Take
that.
Take a look.
I don't, wait a minute, I'm not seeing it. I don't see anything. You guys have the lens cap on. It's off. Are you guys nuts? How do you expect to see anything?
Oh, really? I thought for sure I saw something. It must be our...
Optical sensors.
Yeah.
Yeah, they must need work. Say, Joel, did anyone ever tell you look like Petey from Our Gang?
No, I don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, Joel, time for our trivia quiz.
Okay.
In the mid-60s, what was the slogan of Terry Surgery than cigarettes.
I'd rather fight than switch. That guy, you guys, that wasn't funny at all.
Well, it was funny from where I'm standing.
Hey, crew, what's for dinner? Black-eyed peas?
You better beat it. We got a commercial sign. Is that funny? I'll show you how it works. Let's pretend I'm a woman, okay?
Hey, Jolene, what a lovely wrap you have on.
Oh, Crow, you've got no finesse. Watch and learn from the master. Hey, babe, you, me, Mango Fest. How about it?
I don't think so. I need a real... Wait a minute, this is all wrong. I'm getting off track here. Now, let me explain this to you. On Earth, women carry their valuables in a handbag like this, okay? Now, if we were on there, you could use this, but sometimes criminals try to steal that purse, okay?
Well, what if the women carry a wallet?
Well, if they carry a wallet, it's smaller and it's harder to get at, but I'm mostly concentrating on this handbag.
How about a knapsack?
Okay, Crow. That's enough.
What about one of those funny little coin things that you squeeze the sides and they always seem to rip?
Okay, now listen, Crow. Yeah, listen, Crow. I want you guys to reach way back in your memories and come up with that thug algorithm that I programmed you with.
Okay, okay, I got it. Hey, Vinny! Yo, bro!
Hey, listen, my friend, I'm gonna do you a favor. I'm gonna rip off your butt, wrap it around your neck, and make you an extra pair of shoulderers.
Yes, says who? Okay.
Says me.
I think you guys got it.
You and what army?
Okay, listen. Now, I think you guys got it. I'll play the part of a pedestrian, and you guys try to snatch the purse.
Are you sure you don't want a knapsack?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Okay.
All right, 23 toes. I distract the skirt. You grab the booty, okay? Yo, babe, you, me, mango juice, capiche?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Go for the Crow now, grab the purse, Crow.
Ah! yeah, it's just a thing called hell in a handbag, right? Get it?
I'm sorry, Crow, but the look on your face when it lit up, it kills me.
It almost killed me, too. Joel, why'd you do that?
Well, it's just my way of getting back at you two front-end loader heads for getting that junk all over my eye earlier.
I'm sorry.
We got movie time! We got double time now! All right, you soldiers, pick it up double time now! Lift your head up to the sky!
Lift your head up to the sky!
Satellite love is passing by!
Satellite love is passing by!
I don't know, but I've been told!
I don't know, but I've been told!
Robot contacts made of gold!
Robot contacts made of gold!
We follow Joe wherever he leads!
We follow Joe wherever he leads!
The scientists, however, are a couple dickweeds!
Scientists, however, are a couple dickweeds!
Sound off!
1, 2!
Sound again!
3, 4!
King's call!
1, 2, 3, 4!
1, 2!
3, 4! I don't want to complain, I don't want to whine!
I don't want to complain, I don't want to whine!
Don't look now, it's movie star! Oh, okay, well...
Oh.
Hey, hi, you guys. Hey, Gypsy, where have you been?
Bumping into shining newsletters.
Oh, okay, well...
All day.
All day long? Well, let's show them what they get. Please write in if you like and become a MST3000 member. Yeah, you get the MST3000 fan club certificate suitable for framing.
How come I'm not in that?
Because you drew it. And then you got the MST3000 satellite news and your Mystery Science Theater fan club card. So write in, and we'll see you next time on Mystery Science Theater.
Bye!
Keep those drawings.
Private is taunted by his sadistic sergeant.
Let's try him again.
Every time I try, they hang up.
We've got to get the movie through to them.
Hello, Jolie.
Hello.
Hey, wait a minute. You're not Joel.
That's right.
Is Joel home?
Yes.
Well, can I talk to him?
Yes.
Would you mind getting him?
Hey, sirs.
Don't haser me, you little fishbowl with feet. Get the boss.
You mean Bruce Springsteen?
No. Boss Hogg?
No.
Boss Tweed?
No. Bossy the cow?
No.
This has gone far enough.
Yeah, and without a laugh.
Send those robo-twits Time of the Apes.
Gladly.
Movers down!
Did you look in the commissary?
Well, yes, and in the AG room.
AG room? What's that?
I don't know, anti-gravity, maybe?
Yeah, that sounds good. Well, was he there?
We don't have an anti-gravity room.
Well, then there's no use looking for Joel there, then, is there?
Hey, hang on to your load pan, pal.
Load pan? That's funny coming from a spasmodic crapisator.
Well, at least I don't throculate in a panoric arch, buddy.
Well, maybe you should.
Everybody!
Hey, Gypsy, what's that in your mouth?
It's Joel's uniform. I found it in a pod bay.
What's a pod bay?
Oh, about 2 pounds. That's not important right now, though. What's important is that Gypsy found Joel's suit, and that means...
Joel is floating naked in space. Quick, get the telescope! Oh. Hey, look, the suit almost fits.
You know, Crow, we're in a very interesting situation here. Fact, Joel is floating naked in space.
Mm-hmm.
Fact, Mr. Crow, we have locked the door and hold the only key.
Mm-hmm.
Fact, Joel is at our complete mercy.
You know, we could bring him in, but there'll have to be some changes.
Mm-hmm.
First, we have to dump all these breadfruit plants.
Yes, and a Tahitian babe for everyone.
Yeah, or we could set him adrift in a life pod with a sextant, charts, and our toaster.
A toaster? Not Lucille. She's got 4 toast bays.
Hey, the guy's got to have some fun. What is that infernal pounding?
Must be, space particles. Yeah, that's it. Space particles.
Yeah. Let's fire the retros and shake them loose.
Oh, he's going to be so upset.
Now, which one of these is, movie star!
Thanks for coming to Mystery Science... All right, hey, thanks for coming to Mystery Science Theater 3000. I'm Joel Hodson. The guys at the station sent me this facsimile that the next film is called Invaders from...
He's here, I see him. Servo, don't tell him it was me who wanted to fire the retros.
Hey, wait a minute. Cambot, knock it off. Stop it, just stop.
Boy, that really looked real. I could have sworn that was him.
Crow, do the words videotape mean anything to you?
Okay, smart buckets. If that wasn't Joel, who was it?
Well, that was a simulation. There was no one behind that door.
Oh, really? Let's look.
Oh! Oh! See, that wasn't Joel at all. Really. Reality is something you play with, like silly putty.
Wow, this is really complicated. How does anyone know what's real or not?
Well, take this segment, for example. This is an illusion.
It is? Boy, my head hurts. Can you ever tell what's real or what's not?
Well, here's something that's definitely not reality. Movie suck! Boy, life on the satellite... Boy, life on the satellite without Joel is sure going to be different.
Yeah, no more getting slapped in the load pans.
No more electrocutions for no reason.
No more getting turned into Christmas trees.
Maybe Joel could be a good Christmas tree.
Yeah. I kind of miss him.
Yeah, but I don't mind life here with you, pal.
No. You're the greatest.
Previously on Mystery Science Theater 3000...
Boy, life on the satellite without Joel is sure going to be different.
Yeah, no more getting slapped in the load pans.
No more electrocutions for no reason.
No more getting turned into Christmas trees.
Maybe Joel could be a good Christmas tree.
Yeah, I kind of miss him.
Yeah, but I don't mind life here with you, pal.
No, you're the greatest.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I see him now. I see him. He's not naked. He's got his BVDs on.
Well, what's he doing outside the satellite?
He's holding his breath.
Well, how can you tell that?
His cheeks are blue.
I thought you said he was wearing his DVDs.
Not those cheeks. Open the pod bay door, Lair.
I'm afraid I can't do that.
You bet. Dave. Oh, he's in. He's in.
Well, let's see how our little space herpes doing then.
Come in, Jolene, my little orbiting dove bar.
Thanks for letting me in, sirs. Those pesky robots of mine locked me out of the ship again.
Little domestic problem, eh?
Natives getting restless, huh?
Lunatics taking over the asylum.
Good God, who?
Having a problem with your droids, princess?
Leia? Give me five, Clay.
Take the laugh, Lair.
Oh, great. You guys are torturing me again. That's what I love. I can just look forward to another 12 weeks of this again. Listen, I've got the robot thing under control. Why don't you guys just slap another movie on me?
Okay, Jolene, we've got a little foreign number for you.
This one's got all the accessories to make it a perfect movie for you and the bots. It's got lots of angry blonde babes. It's got Frankie Avalon.
And Wilford Hyde White, and a really, really washed-out print. It's called The Million Eyes of Sumaru. Roll it, Clay.
Rolling.
I can't wait to get my hands on those pesky bots. All right, everybody, movie set! Oh, the same thing happened to you too, didn't it, Crow? Well, maybe you guys will think twice next time you lock me out. That's why I took the liberty of putting on these video probes.
Ah! Oh, it feels so good when the pain stops. It was almost worth it.
You know, we didn't know it was you, Joel. We swear to God, we heard the pounding on the walls. We thought it was Elvis, really.
Or Buddy Rich.
Or Gene Krupa.
Or Keith Moon.
Or, who's the drummer for the Stones?
Charlie Watts, but he isn't dead yet.
Listen, you guys better be quiet or the idio probes go right back where they were.
Hey, look, Joel, this isn't fair at all. We demand a trial by our peers.
Listen, quit talking. If I could build you some more peers, I would. Where's Gypsy? Hey, what's wrong, you guys? Where's Gypsy?
You tell him, Servo.
Oh, thanks. Joel, Gypsy got stuck in the spiral on down.
So you left her there?
You know, Joel, my arms are only ornamental, you know. Well, what did you want me to do?
Well, what about you, Crow?
I did do something.
What?
I panicked.
Great. Now listen, you guys, the solution was here all along. All you would have needed done was press this button here.
You mean there's a robo-purge button on the control?
I'm gonna have a drink,
Joel Watner-Hobson presiding. The Honorable Judge Joel Watner-Hobson presiding.
I heard he's a hanging judge.
Oh, how's it hanging, Judge?
Shh. Order in the court. Bailiff, read the charge.
30 volts.
What?
No, amps. Watts times amp equals volts. WV. West Virginia. West Virginia.
Blue Ridge Mountains.
Can you rephrase that in the form of a question?
Yes. Who is buried in Grant's tomb?
That's right, for $500. You still remain in control of the board. Please select.
I'll have Serbian authors for $200.
$200? That's a great deal. I'll take three.
Order, order.
I just did. I ordered three Serbian authors.
You want fries with that?
No, I'll have the Slavs.
Cold Slavs?
No, cold porter.
Porter, porter, porter.
Can you dig your bag, sir? Porter in the court. Porter in the court.
What do you mean in the court? That ball was out. Are you blind?
Advantage McEnroe.
You're out of order, you
No, guys. You're out of order. You're out of order. We're all out of order. This whole proceeding is out of order.
Sorry, sir. There's no more Slavs.
Oh, well, then I'm not ordering.
Excuse me while I kiss this guy. Movie sign!
5 weeks out. I don't understand. How were you able to survive for 5 weeks outside the spacecraft with no spacesuit on?
Hmm?
Yeah, according to my calculations, you should have just suffered an explosive decompression like in the movie Outland.
Huh? Well, fellas, it's something like this. If you're wondering how he eats and breathes and other science facts, repeat to yourself, it's just a show. Why should we really just relax? Bring it in, Cambot. For Okay, Servo's Mount Servo's boat broken, so I'm moving it for him. Anyway,
too bad.
We've got 900 people in the fan club. Please write in if you want to become a member. You get the membership card, the bonding polymer, the newsletter, and the bonding polymer is the newsletter. And Servo, I'm going to move your mouth. Cambot, let's have the address up on the screen. Here we go.
Mystery Science Theater 3000 Fan Club, care of TV 23, 2505 Kennedy Street Northeast, Minneapolis, Minnesota, 55413.
I don't know how long I want to keep moving your lips like this.
The mandible, the lower mandible is hurt.
Right lower mandible. Anyway, we'll see you later. Thanks again for tuning in on Mystery Science Theater 3000. Yeah. Back to Earth.
Woo!
The movie's called Hangar 18. Movie star! Hey, Carl, I'm going to have to borrow some of your RAM chips later today.
Why?
I'm going to need some more computing power, that's why.
Why?
Because if you want to know, there's a meteor shower heading right for the ship, and that's why.
Why?
Well, if the ship gets in the way of the meteor shower, it'll puncture holes in the side of the ship the size of a six-pack of malt liquor, that's why.
So?
Well, if we have holes in the ship the size of malt liquor cans, it's going to suck all the oxygen out.
So?
So if there's no oxygen in the ship, your creator and pal, me, expires, and that's the end.
So?
So I'll put it in robot terms. That means no human companion for playing Parcheesi. You know how that ends up. No kibbles and bots. And no mid-morning pleasure stimulation. Jeez.
Oh. Well, Daddy, what's Vietnam? Come on, Joe. You got to lighten up. Come on.
Get my belt. Hey. Go to my footlocker and get my belt.
I hate you forever.
Okay, now Servo, this coupling device on Crow's head is going to allow us to read what's in his memory and then decide whether we should keep it or not, what should be saved, what we should dump, all right?
All right, I'll do this monitor here, all right? First we have on.
On. I think that's a given. We should keep that.
Yeah. All righty, keep that. Okay, how to play Heart and Soul with your fist.
Keep that.
Want that.
All right, load pan training.
Well, it's up to you, Joel. Do you really want to go through that again?
No, I don't.
No, I think bunk beds are enough of a reason not to.
Yeah, I don't want to have to use the membrane again.
All right.
Load purge, all the same to me.
Good to hear it. All the King family specials.
Dump.
Here's the solutions to all those highlight magazines.
Dump.
Okay, STP commercials with Mario Andretti.
Dump.
Okay, a still store. Farrah Fawcett's poster from the 70s. Yeah. Better keep that, I think.
Yeah.
All right, well, here's every Punky Brewster episode. Here's the Lyle Wagner penile implant show.
Dump.
Well, all right, okay. Joe Kaufman's business school.
That would be dumb.
Robert Vaughn's Helsinki formula hour. Aaron Gray's cellulite show. George Hamilton's skincare hour.
Crow, where did you pick up all these shows?
Well, I was monitoring TV 23 one night and I fell asleep.
Movie star!
Crow's first memory. Look at this, Joel. It's Crow's first memory.
Wow, we gotta watch it. let's put it up on the screen. All right, the right lower manual connects to the vestigial column. The vestigial column connects to the Newton valve. The Newton valve connects to the spasmodic crophiscator, and that's what makes him throcculate. Dem bots, dry bots, dem bots, dry bots, dem bots, dry bots. Now hear the pan of the load. Well, I'm all out of white pieces. That must be it. That's not right.
Ow! Hey, that hurts. Hey, hello, world!
Hey, welcome to the satellite of love. I'm going to call you Crow.
Why Crow?
Well, Crow stands for Cybernetic Remotely Operated Woman.
Whoa, wait a minute. I'm a woman. Hey, hear me roar, guys. No wonder I got darts in all my clothing.
Well, actually, you're not a woman, Crow. I ran out of parts, and you're a hermaphrobot.
Well, get Radio Shack on the horn and finish the job, boy. Look at this mess. Are these dishes clean? Hey, put that down. You'll poke your eye out. Hey, 30-something's
Crow,
coming on. I got to have some chocolate.
Take it easy, Crow. Listen, you were, it's all just a real elaborate joke, Crow. I basically invented you to put that memory in and pull a joke on you.
So my life has been one big setup for a punchline? Boy, I feel like Maury Amsterdam.
Movie star!
All right, fellas.
That's right.
Okay, it's a very special time around here, isn't that right, fellas?
That's right.
I'm all a quiver with anticipation.
We're almost to our 1,000th member in the MST3000 fan club.
Cool.
Right, and you can become a member by paying attention to this.
Mystery Science Theater Fan Club, care of TV 23, 2505 Kennedy Street Northeast, Minneapolis, Minnesota, 55413.
Right, and we've also got a surprise prize for the 1,000th person.
Ooh.
You want to tell them about it, Don Pardo?
They win self-satisfaction, that's right. Their name mentioned on the air, and one of these attractive, lovely demon dogs is featured in the opening credits of Mystery Science Theater 3000.
Ooh.
Just for sending in your name.
That's right, so don't forget... You get this demon dog if you're the 1,000th winner and your name on the air.
Isn't that a Bowie song, Demon Dog?
No, that's an X song.
I love it.
Thanks.
I don't like this, Clay.
Shut up, Lair. This is an important experiment.
No, let me up. It hurts.
It's supposed to hurt. It's science. Pons and Fleischmann got it wrong. Cold fusion works... But it has to take place in the human mouth.
Wait. Shouldn't we start with, like, a sheep's mouth or something?
No, we don't have the funding for that. Now, open wide.
What is that?
It's just heavy water. Open up. Here comes a steam shovel. Chug. Don't swallow. This is expensive. Now, the secret ingredient. Look, Daddy likes it. Here you go.
It works! Yes! It's great! The best thing is, it tastes like peach blow fizz! That's not cold fusion, that's the dry heaves!
Oh, well, back to the drawing board then. Why don't you send Joel the movie?
Last chase.
Okay, you two, it's time for your humanity lesson, okay?
Oh,
cool. First thing we're going to do is, number one, always say please and thank you, even if you don't mean it, all
check.
Right?
Roger.
Okay, number two, always remember to call your mom, or in your case, me, every weekend.
Roger.
Got it?
Check.
Number three, never let them see a sweat.
Three things, that's it.
Wow, and you keep complaining that life is a sad vale of tears?
Well... Part of being a human being is developing a conscience. That's a big part.
Conscience? What's that?
Well, sound it out. Conscience. Conscience.
You mean a quack scientist?
Yeah, like Eric von Daniken.
Oh, like the guy who wrote Ancient Astronauts, right?
Yeah, see right there, Ancient Astronauts. That's ridiculous. Everybody knows that astronauts have to be between 28 and 45.
Now, by conscience, I mean how you guys felt when you guys locked me out of the ship a couple of weeks ago.
You mean self-satisfied, free from our shackles of bondage?
No, I think I'm going to have to use another example.
Uh-oh. Is this going to be another one of those Bob Newhart stories?
Well, having a conscience is kind of like when you're programmed with the three robotic laws. Now, I've typed up an example here. It's, I'll download a simulated conscience program into your RAM. And this one has an accelerated module with a moralistic add-on, okay? Let's key in some low-level guilt as well.
Oh!
There you go.
What? What's that? Oh, look what you've done to my shirt. Is there something green on me? Is there something in my teeth? Did you put a bug on me? Is there a bug?
Well, sounds great.
Huh?
Yeah, hey, I think I put the wrong module in. It must have been the paranoid module by mistake.
What? What did I do?
Listen, we better go to a commercial. You better have your moralistic add-on while you watch it.
Enjoy.
Going to a commercial?
It's a big day, isn't it, Servo?
Number 1,000
yep.
Fan club member.
Our 1,000th fan club letter. Put it up on the big screen, Canva. Let's have a look. There's the front of it. It says Destination Unknown. See you where no man has gone before. Very post-punk. And here's who it's from. Ms. Gidget Howell.
Oh.
And she says, yes, that's my name, Gidget. The, what would that make her?
The love child of Sally Field and Jim Backus, I guess.
Right.
Gidget, love me. I guess you love me.
Yeah, I guess she did. Okay, Crow, let's have the prize. Did you bring it?
I couldn't find it, Joel. I don't know where the demon dogs are.
Here it is. This is what you won.
The
demon dog hat from the opening credits of the show. You see it wear like that. It's a little bit hard on the skull, but
cool.
What do you want for nothing?
Oh.
We got movie stuff! So on Saturday morning. In my hometown, there was a guy named Commander Paul who had a kids show on Saturday morning. It was really bland. I mean, all he did was show cartoons and tell you the temperature outside. Although once in a while he had a lady from the zoo come over and talk about snakes, or maybe a library person who would talk about books. After Commander Paul left the station, he was replaced by a Commander Dave and then a Commander Tom. They didn't really put much of their own personality into the show. You guys leave them behind by a million miles, and I can't think of anyone else who could do it so well. Thank you. Here's to more Japanese brain-eating space women with Georgia accents.
And I'm Tom Baudet from Motel 6.
That's Anton Marquardt.
Thanks for joining us. We'll leave the light on for you.
See ya.
I'm telling you, Clay, it was brilliant. It sold millions. The Paul is Dead hoax is one of the greatest marketing schemes in history.
And the Joel is Dead campaign is the perfect way to pump some life into the video marketing arm of Mystery Science Theater.
It'll be the biggest marketing coup since Coke changed the formula. Let's review the clues.
Yeah, oh, good, good. I was watching this tape earlier and I picked out some things. Here, look at this. See? Sat one, good. Now, Saturday the first day he died. Brilliant!
Absolutely, all right. Okay, next, look. Next Sunday A.D. A.D. after death. He died on Saturday the 1st. Sunday the 2nd was the funeral.
Now here, in the lyric, in the soundtrack, it says, there was a guy named Joel. Not is, was.
Well done.
Thank you.
Very nice. Very nice. Okay, here's my final one. Okay, look in the opening segment here. He has really long hair. Nowhere else in the show does he have that kind of hair.
Yeah.
You know what they say? Hair keeps growing after death. So Peter Tork, too. Peter Tork, he looks like Peter Tork. He has long hair. The monkeys are kind of dead. You know what I'm... They're going to love it.
I'm not buying that. I think that's reaching a little bit,
okay.
Larry.
All right. It's for money. It's money involved.
Well, I understand. I think it's a good idea. Oh, here's one. I took the liberty of retouching the cover of the Abbey Road album. And you can see I put Joel's head where Paul is. You know, the whole barefoot cigarette thing.
This is beautiful.
Yep, yeah.
Well, excellent work.
Paul, thank you. I used to do retouch work for the Inquirer.
Let's see what Weasley... Let's see what Joel... Joel, what do you think, pal?
Well, it'll probably work, but don't you think it'll make you feel bad inside?
Feel bad inside? We always feel bad inside.
We just write it off as gas.
Yeah, besides... We need to raise $20 million for our new theme park, Six Flags Over 10 to the 12th Power.
I don't think I feel like participating in your little hoax.
Who asked you?
Yeah, last time I checked, the control switches were still here on Earth.
Anyway, it's a dinosaur film, and it's without Doug McClure. It's called Legend of the Dinosaurs.
There's just one thing I want to know. Is it a Sandy Frank film?
Yes!
But you know what I say, never trust a man with two first names, especially if the first one's a woman's. Move inside! Hey, you guys, now remember the last sequence, how we made ourselves look huge by having small sets, right?
It was brilliant.
Well, thanks, but Cambot and I have rigged up something that'll make us look really small. Cambot, let's go. No!
Oh my God!
He's gone!
Watch out!
Well, that cast sort of a dim shadow on the evening.
Hmm.
Was kind of a special effect, though.
Yeah, only in the way that Bob Hope is special.
We'll be right back.
Boy, the satellite of love is sure a mess. We better get it clean before Joel comes. Oh, servo!
Hi, Crow. Hello, everybody. Oh, did I have a night. There were lots of beautiful babes and fanning and...
Don't make me ask. Mango juice.
Yep, it was mango mania.
And then you woke up.
What? We better get this mess cleaned up or Joel is gonna be mad.
Did somebody say my name? Hey, boys. Boy, this place is a mess.
Yeah, and it's dirty, too.
Well, if I've learned anything about life, it's no matter where you go in this crazy universe, you turn around and there's your mom.
Good night!
Good night,
everybody!
Okay, Cambot, turn off the TV sitcom simulator. That's right. I thought that was pretty good.
Yeah, that was great. I felt just like Donna Reed.
What you talking about, Crow?
Movie star! Now, you guys, in this next sequence that we're going to see in The Legend of the Dinosaur, there's going to be some full-blown, no-holds-barred, backdoor action dinosaur style.
I'm all a-quiver with anticipation, okay. Joel.
Now, I want to teach you a little bit about how movie magic works. You see this Kentucky Fried Chicken? Took the liberty of putting a little styling mousse on the roof there, and this is what we call in scale. Now, if the Kentucky Fried Chicken was really that size, we'd be huge, right?
Absolutely. I think I'd be like a water tower. Crow looks like Underdog from the Macy's Parade.
Oh, I don't like it. I'm afraid of heights. What if I fall off myself?
Well, you know what they say. If you fall off yourself, you just gotta get back on.
Well, anyway, you guys, I built this dinosaur to breathe fire, and I'll show you how it works, okay? We turn them on. Light him up.
Whoa!
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 Whoa! Dragon mouth. Oh!
He's got the worst breath of the morning.
Yeah.
Chronic halitosis.
Hey, I got a question. Tyrannosaurus Rex really didn't breathe fire, so this one isn't anatomically correct.
Oh, but he is.
Movie star!
For the summer.
Remember, we're going to tell everybody that we're going on hiatus now.
For the summer.
For the summer. What are you going to do for the summer, Crow?
I'm going to space camp.
Space camp. Okay. And Servo, what are you going to do?
I'm going to fill my head with cocoa butter and surf till I drop.
Great. I'm going to be working on my Bob Hope impression this summer.
Let's hear it.
Want to hear it? Yeah, I love the kids of the day. I love that Swedish hotcake, Elky Summers. Boy, I don't want to really complain about Exxon, but... now I know why they call them tankers.
Exxon's grasping now. All their stations have our gas contains no seawater signs.
Yeah.
Regular unleaded or desalinated.
Whoa. What anyway. A year. We went from Ollie North to Oily North.
Whoa. Oh.
Anyway, boom. Zing.
Thanks, everybody who's been supporting this show. Yeah. We really appreciate it. All the people in the fan club, and especially our friends here at TV23.
If you like the show, write in and tell the station.
Right. I think that ought to do it. Yeah. Bye, everybody.
See ya.
Bye.
An artist moves to a tropical island after seeing two marriages go bad, only to have his self-imposed isolation interrupted by his three sons. George C. Scott stars in the Hemingway classic, Islands in the Stream, next on the Sunday Evening Movie. Tomorrow night, don't miss the fast-paced Western action of Calamity Jane. Monday's movie at 7 on Minnesota's Movie Star, KTMA TV 23.